save a Minnesota car, save the dinosaurs and the waterfalls and crap.
Customer. And what brings you to our little store this evening?
I'm looking for a gift for my father. He likes this sort of stuff.
Well, you'll find plenty of stuff here. I assure you.
That's too true. We got rocks to look at, sticks to scratch with, and a pit of vipers out back.
Okay, oh, Merbiddle, wouldn't you like to go to the storeroom? On my desk, there's a whole book of stamps, and you can lick them all.
Okay, well, I whipped up a batch of pork rinds. If you want any, just go ahead.
It's in the storeroom.
It's in the storeroom.
I'm sorry. That's my sister, Merbiddle. I own this store with her and my brother. My brother's a jackass. He's around here somewhere.
Toilet's plugged.
Excuse me, I'm with a customer.
Well, it's plugged. Have you been flushing womanly napkins down it?
What would I be doing with womanly napkins?
They got a variety of uses.
Now, where... Oh, my. That smell.
I'm sorry, I just came from Orange City.
No. Is that new car smell?
Yes, it is. My father helped me get the loan, so I wanted to give him a gift.
Oh, how nice. Anything in particular?
No, I think I'll just look around.
Let me know if you need anything. What are you doing? What's that on your head?
Earmuffs.
Are those
womanly napkins?
What's your name? Corey. This is Candy Cane. She knows your name, you know. Really? She says it's Corey. You told her my name. That'll be $5. What am I saying? I'm not paying you $5.
How can you deny her $5? Candy Cane is the cutest pet. You got a new car!
Yeah, how did you know that?
Who knew it was new?
Will you excuse us, please, for a little bit? You still doing all right? Okay, look, I've got some news for you guys. This isn't just a store for me, all right? It's an investment.
Little man likes big words.
Look, you're my siblings. When you came to me, asking me to buy this store, I went all in, didn't I? I helped you as best I could.
And we appreciate it.
So what that means is, when a customer comes into the store, what you're going to do is, you're going to ask them what they want, and then you're going to provide that to them. And that means no more Mystic Hamster. And that means no more homemade earmuffs. You got that?
And we got news for you.
We're wanting to get married.
What?
Jervis looks jealous.
It's Jermaine! It's Jermaine! He's a customer.
Oh, no, you cannot do that! You are fired!
Can I help you?
Yes, I am Francis LeTrout, the famous chef. And if I seem to be overacting, it's because I am French.
I got me a hankering for some freedom fries and frog legs.
I enjoy bubbly water and beautiful women. And I have just fired the general manager of a world-renowned restaurant, the Fruited Plain. Humph. Trying to sell content not worth consuming. Humph.
How can I help you, sir?
I am here for my eggs!
I'll be right with you, Francis.
Excuse me, sir.
Excuse me. Yes?
What's that up there? I really like it.
Oh, that's the Doherty. Everybody wants one of those. That's why I keep it just out of everybody's reach.
You know what I really would like? My father is really proud of his home state. Do you have any of those South Dakota turd birds?
Sadly, madam, we do not.
Just give me 10 minutes and a newspaper, and I'll whip one right up.
I gotta go.
Madam, we can find you what you need. We've got sticks you can scratch with. Sticks you can scratch with!
So, you need a new general manager, huh?
You figured it out, you silly American.
Yeah. Well, I'm available. I could start tonight.
Very well, but we must leave now, and you must run alongside the car.
I've got my own car.
You must run alongside the car.
I will. Let me say goodbye. Ah. Well, congratulations. The store is yours. I've had it. I'll fax the papers over in the morning. See you at Christmas.
Oh, Christmas ain't for months.
Wait.
I was just checking to see if you had woman parts.